Tom from the Metalheadz Show here at the Roadhouse in Manchester with Brandon of Monster Truck. How are you today?
Great, Tom. How about you?
I'm very good, thank you. So tonight you'll be playing the final date of the first ever Lords of the Riff tour, and it's been a co-headliner between yourselves and Scorpion Child with support from Buffalo Summer. How's the tour been so far?
Really awesome. We couldn't be happier with the other bands we're playing with, the crowds that have been coming out, the clubs are good clubs that are kind of legendary, or so we've discovered. It feels awesome. We feel triumphant. We're triumphant lords.
So there's been any crazy tour moments?
Last night in London at the Underworld, that was pretty crazy. 500 people at any show is pretty awesome, but then you're there in Camden Town and all the, there's lots of big press, we did a Metal Hammer feature thing, and all the big guns were in town, our agent was there, all the press people are there, and it was really, that was pretty surreal. But honestly, every show has been pretty electric in the room. Glasgow was awesome. There's too many awesome moments, really. Yeah.
Awesome. What would you say was your favorite show of the tour, though?
Geez, that's a tough one.
Or most memorable?
I'm going to go with last night, Underworld. The London one was so big. It was pumped up by everybody. And it felt like it was building towards that. The routing of the tour was really good to kind of ramp it up the whole way around. Everything kind of culminated, and every band played really great last night, and the fans were just crazy, so.
Awesome. So last year you released your debut album, Furiosity. How did yourself and the rest of the band react to the amount of great press it was receiving?
We were kind of overwhelmed, a little bit taken back. We didn't know what to expect. You know, at home in Canada, we knew we had started something, or we had the two EPs that got some good recognition and really built our name up. So we were hoping just to keep on improving that in Canada, and things kind of went even further than we expected. And then to have you guys over here getting on board as good as you have, as well mainland Europe, it's pretty shocking.
So how would you sell the album to someone who hasn't heard it yet?
It's pretty much an awesome mixture of old and new rock. Yeah. We're children of the new age. We can't deny that. And we played in punk bands and metal bands and, you know, grungy bands and all that. But we love that old rock, and we try to marry the two. So yeah. it sounds like that.
So how did you guys celebrate winning the Breakthrough Group of the Year award at last year's Junos?
Same type of overwhelming feeling. We went out. It was the big party night, because we won it on the TV awards, which happen on the Sunday night, which is when all the labels have their big parties, and that's when everyone gets dressed up and goes out. So we just got nice and drunk with all our other buddies in the bands and who were there, and just went party to party, and you know, kind of in bewilderment, because we didn't expect to win in the least. So
this tour is pretty mixed in terms of nationalities. I mean, we have you guys from Canada, we have a Scorpion Child from Texas, and we have Buffalo Summer from South Wales. But I wanted to ask you, which country do you think has contributed the best bands to rock and roll?
Oh, geez, you gotta give everybody the benefit of the doubt, but especially America and Britain. It's really, America kind of created it. They started it. And then the British took a hold of it and kind of shook things up, which in turn motivated the Americans again. And then it's kind of just been a one big ball of crazy rock since then. And now anyone can do it from anywhere, because everyone's drawing on those same influences. Yeah. So USA and Britain, absolutely.
So who would you say is the most influential rock and roll bands for you?
For the band or for myself personally?
Both.
Definitely for the band. I think we like to talk about, you know, Led Zeppelin and Deep Purple and Black Sabbath and all those old ones, but we're also influenced by that stuff we grew up with. Nirvana, Soundgarden, Rage Against the Machine. A lot of punk rock stuff. Some of us were punker kids. But you know, it's, you've got to mix all that stuff together. That's what makes us who we are. Me personally, I love the Beatles and the Beach Boys. I kind of grew up with that stuff. My mom always played that, so I like that poppy old 60s stuff. The Who is super cool, so I like Bob Dylan too. But I mean, it runs the gamut. I also love Led Zeppelin and Deep Purple. So, and so much since then. It's just, there's so much to choose from that it's never ending. It's hard to find new bands when I'm still finding old ones.
Yeah. Awesome. And a final question, other than like a lot of touring and summer festivals, what are Monster Truck's plans for the rest of the year?
We are trying to get ready to record in and amongst all this festival. It's because we're, as soon as we're done here, we're going to the mainland Europe for 2 weeks. Then we go to America for a tour with Alter Bridge, followed instantly by a tour with Alice in Chains. Wow. Then we'll get home and the festivals begin. But we're really trying to write and get songs ready to go so that when we do stop playing shows, we can go right to the studio and record. So hopefully, though, we would like to come back here in the fall. Yeah, we'd like to tour throughout the fall anywhere, but especially over here, because we're here now and it's going so well. But
great. Well, thanks so much for speaking to us. Have a great show tonight.
Thanks very much.